I am Antonella Angiolillo from University of Molise in Italy, and good afternoon, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for this invitation. And my presentation will focus on metabolomics as an important tool to search for Alzheimer's disease biomarkers. Alzheimer's disease is one of the most common forms of dementia among the elderly. It's a progressive and fatal neurodegenerative disorders that slowly destroys cognitive functions. Currently, the pathology affects 47 million people worldwide, and the number, unfortunately, is likely to triple by 2050. The diagnosis of Alzheimer's is, to date, it's clinical. A variety of approaches and tools can help for the diagnosis. But to date, there are no simple, non-invasive and inexpensive biomarkers. In the recent years, the search for new predictive diagnostic and prognostic biomarkers has been gaining increasing attention from the world communities, scientific community, since new strategies are needed for an area. So in this context, the metabolomics looks very promising. For this purpose, our study aimed at evaluating any differences in plasma metabolic composition between a group of individuals with Alzheimer's disease and a group of healthy controls to identify new, maybe more variable biomarkers of this disease. 20 subjects were examined in our study, Alzheimer's and 10 healthy controls. Each subject underwent a series of cognitive tests, here Ryan reported, and to allow the inclusion in the right category. Metabolites were measured by flow injection analysis and liquid chromatography tandem mass spectrometry using the BioCRATS MXP Quant 500 assay. The analysis had been done by the BioCRATS. And the statistical analysis was performed using the package MetaboAnalyst. The data collected were first analyzed using the t-test to obtain an overview of differences in the concentration of the different metabolites between the two groups. The table here, maybe I can use the pointer. Okay. The table shows the 22 metabolites, which among the 630 metabolites that were examined, they show significantly different plasma concentration in the two groups. And this was indicated by the p-value less than 0.05, except for one, for the glutamic acid, all were significantly increased in patients compared to healthy ones. The data were then analyzed using two variants of PRS-DA, the sparse and the orthogonal PRS-DA. Both of them were able to separate the group of patients with Alzheimer's and the control group. But the orthogonal, we can see it here on the right, showed a clearer separation between the two populations. Curve was constructed for each of the 22 metabolites, and the AUC, the area under the curve, was calculated. And this provides a measure of test accuracy, as we can see here in the table. As an example, I also reported here the curve for the metabolites with the highest AUC value. Okay. We also constructed a multivariate rock analysis using the metabolites that showed an AUC value greater than 0.7. And this is the value from which the test is considered accurate. And the 10 metabolites were identified. We can see them on the left. Starting from a maximum AUC of 0.82 in the univariate analysis, The combination of these 10 metabolites in a multivariate analysis here on the right allowed to reach an excellent potency in discriminating the two groups. This is indicated by the AUC of 0.96. An equally excellent discriminate power with an AUC of 0.95 was obtained by combining only these four metabolites. In conclusion, the simultaneous analysis in this study of such a large number of metabolites allowed the identification of two different panels of metabolites with an excellent discriminatory power between Alzheimer's subjects and healthy people. Of course, the present is a pilot study carried out on a small sample, which needs further confirmation on a higher number of subjects. But such preliminary results suggest that metabolomics could be used as an important tool for searching new biomarkers of Alzheimer's. Thank you for your attention.